Hi students, today we are going to do the chapter Deep Water from your book Flamingo, and it has been written by William Orville Douglas. William Douglas was born in Maine, Minnesota, and was raised in Yakima, Washington. He was an American jurist and politician. He served as an Associate Justice of the Supreme Court of the United States. Douglas was nominated at the age of 40 by President Franklin Roosevelt, and was the youngest justice appointed to the court and served for the longest term in the history of the Supreme Court. The chapter Deep Water is an autobiographical description of how the author develops the fear of water and thereafter how he finally overcame it. So the story is about overcoming one's fear. It conveys the idea that fear is a great obstacle to our happiness and progress. It's a negative feeling which paralyzes us and makes us passive. We cannot avoid it, but we can overcome it with persistent efforts, determination, courage, and willpower. It also focuses on the fact that childhood fears must never be treated lightly. If they are not tackled properly, then they make deep inroads into one's psychology. Gist of the story. William Douglas had a great desire to learn swimming since his childhood. At the age of 3 or 4, he was knocked down and buried by a wave at the beach in California. He developed a great aversion to water. At the age of 10 or 12, he decided to learn to swim with water wings at the YMCA pool since it was safe at the shallow end. One day he was sitting alone at the YMCA pool and waiting for others to come. A big boy came and threw Douglas into the deep end of the pool. Douglas swallowed water and went straight down to the bottom of the pool. He crossed to oblivion. When revived, he found himself vomiting beside the pool. He was in a grip of fear of water, and it deprived him of the joys of canoeing, boating, swimming, and fishing. To overcome his fear of water, Douglas hired an instructor to learn swimming. The instructor taught him swimming piece by piece. The writer went to different lakes to swim and found tiny vestiges of fear still gripped him. He challenged the fear and swam. It took Douglas almost 7 months to overcome his fear. But finally, he proved that it was courage, determination, desire, diligence, and optimism that made him get rid of fear. He realized that in death there is peace, but there is terror only in the fear of death. Now the detailed explanation of the chapter. William Douglas had a great passion for water. He longed to learn swimming. When he was 3 or 4 years old, he was taken to a beach in California by his father. While surfing on the shore, a huge wave knocked him down. Knocked him down means threw him down. So when William Douglas, he was on the shore, a huge wave pushed him down and he was almost buried down in water. He felt suffocated and frightened. His father laughed and tried to make him feel comfortable, but the little child was scared when he realized that the waves are so powerful. That was his childhood fear. When Douglas was 10 or 11 years old, he longed to swim in the Yakima River, but his mother warned him against that idea. The Yakima River is treacherous. It means it is dangerous. Then he found the YMCA pool in Yakima, the safest place for swimming. YMCA pool means Young Men's Christians Association, and Yakima is a place in Washington, USA. So it was 2 or 3 feet deep at the shallow end and 9 feet at the deep end. The bottom was tiled and the drop towards the deep part was gradual. Water was clean there and other children were also coming for swimming. So it was a safe place even for the beginners. He got a pair of water wings and went to the pool. The pool reminded him of the horrible experience in water, but he regained his confidence by imitating other boys. But this renewed confidence was soon shattered One day William, he was sitting at the YMCA pool and waiting for the other boys to come. A big boy came. He was around 18 years of age and he had a well-built body with rippling muscles. He seemed to be a bully. The boy asked Douglas if he wanted to be ducked and he picked him up and tossed him into the deep end of the water. Here, duck means to push or plunge someone underwater. So the boy thought that William Douglas, he knew swimming. So the writer, he fell in the water in the sitting position. Douglas knew that he was going to drown as he didn't know swimming. But even then, he was not out of his wits. On his way down the pool, William planned that when he hit the bottom, he would bob to the surface like a cork and swam to the edge of the pool. Bob means jump. So the boy planned that he would make a big jump upward and come to the surface. He had thought that the next moment he would be out of the pool. So when his feet touched the bottom of the pool, he gathered all his strength and jumped upwards. But he came up slowly. What he thought didn't happen. It took a long time to reach him to the bottom of the pool. The 9 feet were more like 90. He came up slowly. He couldn't hold his breath and felt as if his lungs would burst. The boy tried to grab a rope, but his hands clutched only water. He was terrified and felt suffocated. He tried to scream for help, but no sound came out of his mouth. His eyes and nose came out of the water, but his mouth remained in it. He flailed his hands at the surface of the water. Flailed means waved. But he swallowed water and felt choked. He felt his legs had become stiff and rigid like lifeless things. William tried to grab something, but there was water all around. Then Douglas went back to the bottom for the second time. Panic seized him. So when Douglas was going to the bottom for the second time, he compared his situation to a person who saw a nightmare and fought against a dreadful dream, but was unable to ward it off. Ward it off means prevent him from. So the boy, he was not able to save himself from that nightmare. He lost his breath, his lungs ached, his head throbbed, and he felt dizzy. But he could realize that he was alive as he shook and trembled with fright. He did not give up and tried to save himself. He jumped with all his strength, but all in vain. He looked for ropes, water wings, ladder, but he found water only. Now he was not able to move his arms and legs. He tried to call for help. He called his mother, but nothing happened. And then there was a light. He came out of the water. 3 times he went down, and when he went down for the 3rd time, he crossed to oblivion. Oblivion means the state of being unaware and unconscious of what is happening around, and the curtain of life fell. It means life came to an end. So Douglas, he felt that his life came to an end. He sucked water as he tried to breathe air. Then all his efforts stopped. He had a blackout. Everything became quiet and calm. So Douglas, he gave a vivid description of death, which is peaceful. He said that he felt his body floated on the surface and he felt nice to be carried in his mother's arms as he felt sleepy. There is no panic. Everything was quiet and peaceful. But when he regained consciousness, he saw himself lying on his stomach beside the pool vomiting. He had escaped death. Someone dragged him out of the water and provided him first aid. William Douglas also heard that someone was scolding the boy who had pushed him into the pool. After many hours, William reached home. He felt weak and shivered. He kept crying and was unable to eat food. The fear kept haunting him for many days. The incident made him physically upset. After this incident, Douglas tried to avoid water and water sports as much as possible. When he grew up, water began to tempt him again. William came to know the waters of the Cascades and wanted to go into it. Whenever he went for swimming in different rivers like the Titan, Bumping River, Warm Lake of the Goat Rocks, the fear of water returned. It would grab him completely. So the fear of water remained with William as he grew up. On the boarding trips to different lakes in the Maine region, New Hampshire, Deschutes, Metolius, Columbia, and Bumping Lake, where he fished different varieties of fish, namely salmon, bass, and trout, the fear followed him. His fishing trips were destroyed as he did not enjoy boating and swimming due to the fear. Then William decided to overcome his fear. Finally, in the month of October, he hired an instructor to teach him swimming. He would practice for an hour each day, 5 days a week. William described his learning process. A rope attached to a belt was put around the author. The rope went through an overhead pulley and was held by the instructor. It ensured that in case William drowned, the instructor would pull him out. William swam across the length of the pool for several weeks. Whenever the instructor loosened the rope, he went into the water and the fear would return. It would immobilize his legs. It was after 3 months of practice that William got comfortable. He learned to keep his face under and exhale and to raise his nose and inhale. Initially, his legs did not move, but gradually they relaxed and finally could order them to kick in the desired way. He also tried to swim alone in the pool. In order to shed his fear completely, he went to Warm Lake and swam there. He swam in different styles: crawl, breaststroke, side stroke, and backstroke. The terror returned only once when he was in the middle of the lake. When he put his head under water, he saw water all around and the fear returned. This time the author laughed at the terror and said to it that it could not harm him. He saw that the terror vanished and he resumed swimming. The author still had some doubt about the fear, so he started a self-training. He went to the following rivers and lakes: Lake Wentworth, New Hampshire, Triggs Islands, Stamp Act Island, Titan, Conrad Meadows, Conrad Creek Trail, Mead Glacier, Warm Lake, and in the end, he conquered the fear of water forever. The experience had a great importance in William's life. He realized that death is peaceful and only the fear of death is fearful. Douglas realized the truth of Roosevelt's statement: all we have to fear is fear itself. No doubt, if one wants to live a fulfilled life, one must get rid of all kinds of fear that restrict one's happiness. One needs to be strong and determined like Douglas to overcome fear. It was only due to his willpower and perseverance that the instructor could build swimmer out of it. As Douglas had experienced death and the fear of death, his desire to live grew immensely. He tried to draw a larger meaning from this experience. He wants to highlight the fact that his life became meaningful and the desire to live grew immense. Once he had conquered his fear, he felt released from fear and was free to walk up the trails and climb up the mountains fearlessly. There is a very deep message in the story. The author wants to convey that we should convince ourselves that it is not death, but the fear of death that brings terror and panic to our minds. No one is immortal. Each person has to die one day. Once we accept the inevitability of death, we will overcome the fear of death. We should endeavor not to allow the past fears to spoil our present pleasures and make consistent efforts to overcome it. Fear is just a state of mind. In life, situations are risky at times. One must have the courage to overcome them boldly. It is only through courage, desire, determination, and optimism that man has succeeded in making the impossible possible.